Ya, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
Waalaikumsalam
wabarakatuh.
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everybody.
Morning, Miss.
Good morning, Miss.
How are you this morning?
I'm okay, Miss.
Okay, everybody has already got breakfast.
Yes, Miss.
No.
No?
No, Miss.
No, some of you say yes, some of you say no. Okay, Haris, what kind of breakfast did you eat this morning?
White rice.
Oh, fried rice, okay. Mm. You cook by yourself or you buy it?
I cook, Miss.
You cook, okay. Pinter masak berarti ya?
Sedikit, Miss.
Tadi yang bilang no siapa? Fania, have you have breakfast?
No, Miss.
No. Okay. So you haven't eat anything this morning? Or maybe you drink some milk? You eat some bread?
I drink a cup of tea.
Cup of tea, yeah. Jadi kalau sarapan tuh nggak perlu nasi ya. Okay, anything what you eat in the morning is belong to breakfast. Maybe you eat some fruit, you eat some bread, you eat some, or maybe you have snacking ya, ngemil gitu juga termasuk sarapan. Yang penting sudah ada yang ganjel di perut ya. Kalau nggak sarapan nanti you have already so sleepy when you have the class. Tapi semuanya sudah mandi. Have you have take a bath?
Yes, Miss.
Yes, ya. Yeah. Kalau nggak mandi nanti ngantuk, nanti di kelas ngantuk, apalagi kelasnya daring, ya. Yeah. You turn off your video, then you just listen my voice through the handphone. Okay, biasanya seperti itu. But it's okay. There are 75. Participant was already join the class. I will start the meeting today. Alright, so for the first meeting live in an online class, you are going to be with me, yeah, because we have already done with Bu Dewi and Bu Lutfi. Okay, if this is the five last meeting with me, you are going to have the rest. Five topic in your textbook. Is it okay for me to teach to explain in a full English or mix in a Bahasa Indonesia?
Mix Bahasa Indonesia, Miss.
Mix. Dicampur pakai Bahasa Indonesia. This is English for nursing too, ya. Yeah. Ini kan Bahasa Inggris 2, biasanya itu full English. Kalau bahasa Inggris 1 itu masih boleh mix. Masih mau yang mix. Not full English.
Masih, Miss. Takutnya nggak ngerti, Miss.
Oh, I see. Oke, okay. Jadi mungkin I will mix in bahasa Indonesia, but maybe 75% in English and 25% in Indonesia. Is it okay?
Okay, Miss.
All right.
Okay.
It's not easy for me to introduce myself, yeah, because time was already gone. Saya takutnya nggak, ini nanti nggak nutut waktunya. Because we have two topic in this meeting, okay. If in your textbooks you have the listening theory and also presentation theory for part one and part two, but here I will explain for the topic of presentations. Jadi untuk yang listening, saya skip dulu, nanti saya sampaikan di akhir ya, pertemuan terakhir. Hari ini kita akan membahas yang presentation. If I not mistaken, in unit 10. Ya, yeah. Kalau di buku halaman 70, unit 10. Unit
yes,
10
miss.
On page 70.
Yes, miss.
Alright, I will share the screen. Ok, Okay, so it will divide it into two. The first one is theory of presentation part one, and next you are going to have presentation part two. Okay, you may interrupt me, or maybe you have if I'm too slow or maybe too fast. Jadi silakan diinterupsi ya kalau misalnya nanti terlalu cepat atau terlalu lambat. In explaining the topics, yeah. Alright, in your textbook there are the objective of learnings. There are the objective of learnings means you have to master in presentations. Okay, I think it's not familiar with you. It is very familiar with you about the presentation. Karena kalau presentasi itu sudah melekat ya, mulai dari mungkin zamannya SMA, apalagi kuliah, presentasi itu sudah makanan sehari-hari ya. You have already done it well, but how to present in English? Cuma di sini nanti latihannya adalah you present in English. Have you ever experienced delivering some presentation in English? Anyone here? Pernah pengalaman nggak presentasi menggunakan bahasa Inggris?
Belum pernah, Miss.
Belum pernah. Yang lainnya?
Belum pernah, Miss.
Belum pernah.
When you have in a senior high school or in the first when you have English day, maybe no.
No, Miss.
No, okay. Kalau no nanti saya kasih tugas presentasi bahasa Inggris ya. Jangan khawatir, nanti akan pengalaman untuk you have presence in English. Whether it is in group or whether it is in individuals. Jadi nanti untuk praktiknya, ini kan masih teori, kalau praktiknya nanti luring, you have to present in English and also in group or individual. The most important thing when you have a present in English is how you confident with your English. How to speak in English confidently. Itu sebenarnya. Kuncinya kalau presentasi itu adalah confidence with your speaking English. Okay. What is presentation? Kalau di buku di sana ada ya pengertiannya. The definition in your textbooks mean making presentation is a way of communicating your thought, information, ideas to the audience. Okay, so this is only the definition of presentations. Okay, the type of presentation atau the purpose when you have presentations, there are four. Yeah, in your textbook also mentions the four type of presentation. Jadi di buku juga ada empat macam apa saja. To inform, what the meaning of to inform?
Informasikan.
Ya, jadi presentasi yang tujuannya adalah untuk menginformasi. Ya, okay. What is the example of to inform here?
Anu, Miss. Berita, Miss.
Berita. Okay. Apa bahasa Inggrisnya berita?
Gak tahu, Miss.
Gak tahu. Yang lain apa? Berita apa berita?
News, Miss.
News. Okay. News, ya. Yeah. Okay, have you ever experienced in watching news in English? Biasanya suka lihat berita yang pakai bahasa Inggris atau Indonesia?
Indonesia dong, Miss. Kita kan cinta Indonesia.
Ya. Atau mungkin lihatnya sinetron ya? Nggak lihat berita ya? Okay, kalau biasanya ada kok di Metro TV ya, yang memang khusus English news, atau mungkin yang channel yang memang English news. Okay, next, after we have to inform, we have to entertain. So what does it mean by entertain?
Untuk menghibur.
Untuk menghibur. What is the example? Contohnya apa biasanya entertain?
Pelawak, Miss.
Apa? Pelawak? Apa pelawak in English?
Jokes.
Jokes or comedy, ya? Okay, comedy or jokes is belong to entertaining, so right. In this example of entertaining, mean entertainment, especially for the program on the TV, ya. Biasanya di televisi atau mungkin jarang sih live, ya. And then the next one is to persuade. What does it mean by persuade?
Membujuk.
Membujuk. Apalagi kata lain dari membujuk?
Promote, Miss.
Promote, yeah. To promote. Okay. The other word of to persuade means to promote. Okay. What is the example of this one?
Sales, Miss. Promotes in product, Miss.
Yes, biasanya ini adalah sales, ya. Yeah. To promote the product or maybe some marketing, ya. Yeah, to promote in order you have attractive to the product itself. You want to buy the product and so on. Jadi to persuade. And the last one is to inspire. Inspire means?
Untuk
menginspirasi. Motivate, yeah.
Motivasi. Yes, to motivate.
Motivate,
okay. Biasanya siapa? Tokoh yang have you already know the...
Mario Teguh, Miss. Mario Teguh.
Mario Teguh, oke. Okay. Mario Teguh terkenal dengan inspiring man, ya. Oke, okay. Yes, what else? Siapa lagi biasanya tokoh yang motivator atau inspiring woman or men?
Najwa Shihab, Miss.
Najwa Shihab, Miss.
Oke, okay. Najwa Shihab, ya. Ini sudah kelihatan biasanya malam Rabu sama Najwa Shihab, ya. Okay, so to inspire means to motivate others. Okay, in your presentations, yeah, it's mostly you have to inform. Yeah, jadi biasanya kalau presentasi yang biasa kalian presentasikan itu mostly to inform, ya. Yeah? Okay, but it's not needed for you. But it's okay for you to combine this kind of the purpose. Jadi misalnya nanti kalau mau presentasi mau dikombin dengan entertaining is okay, mau dikombin dengan inspiring is okay, or persuading is okay. Contohnya, when you give some tips, yeah, to present some tips. Misalnya tipnya how to get a diet, how to lose weight. Yeah, in a month for 4 kilograms, for example. Jadi di sini biasanya healthy diet itu kan juga informasi, tapi juga to persuade atau juga bisa to inspire. This belong to it depend on the topic that you are going to present. Jadi kalau bisa nanti, when you have the task for the presentations here, it's not needed for you only take the one of the purpose. You may combining this all the purpose or 2, 3 all the purposes here. Bisa combining 1, 2 atau semuanya. Jadi itu nanti akan mempunyai nilai lebih tersendiri, ya. Alright, so after we have already discussing the purpose of this presentations in your textbook, there are the structure of presentation. Kalau di sini adalah part of presentation. Kalau di buku itu penjelasannya adalah part of presentations. Apa saja part-partnya atau strukturnya? Yang pertama adalah how you greet your audience. Okay, greeting your audience means you have to greet the audience based on your situations here. It can be good morning, good afternoon, and so on. Atau kalau kita budayanya biasanya assalamualaikum terlebih dahulu, ya. And then after this, you have to introduce yourself. Okay, introduce yourself, who you are. Maybe you are in a group or you are an individual, you may say your name. And then you have to outline your talk. Okay, outlining your talks here means you have to set your visual presentation through PowerPoint is okay, two slides is okay, through handbook or maybe brochure or maybe the video. This is your outlining your talk. It is to help you in present your topics here. Jadi ini untuk mempermudah ya. Next, you have moved to the body. The body here means the content of your presentation. How you deliver the content of your topic presentations. And after the topics here, you have to summarizing your main points. Ya, jadi kalau sudah dijelaskan, baru di summarize. Okay, after summarize, you have conclude your talk. Okay, jadi kalau di sini summarize poinnya, kemudian concluding your talk, after this you invite the questions here. Okay, inviting the question, maybe you can slip in this main body or in the summarizing here. Biasanya question itu ada di akhir-akhir ya. Okay, tapi if you wanna engage your audience, you may slip in this body or the content in your delivering your topic. And after this, you have to end or close your presentation by accepting the question and give the comment. And after this, you have to be thankful to your audience. Okay. Ini hanya structure-nya saja. Kalau di buku itu ada preparing, ya. Preparing itu sebelum dimulai presentasi biasanya menyiapkan apa saja. Menyiapkan topik ya, dalam bentuk PowerPoint bisa, video, and any other visual presentation you have already made. And then after this, you have the opening, greeting the audience, and then delivering. So you explain about the topic, and then you have the closing. Alright, this is the part or the structure of presentations. Next, how you present on your greetings of your on your audience, I mean. Okay, ini hanya contoh saja. Kalau di buku sudah jelas juga, on page 71 ya, di buku itu halaman 71. Okay, how to opening di sini ya. Okay, how to open, bukan opening. Atau opening the presentation, nggak pakai how to di buku. Okay, how to open, karena ada to itu harus verb satu, bukan verb ing. How to open the presentation. The first one is you start your presentation by greeting and welcoming the audience with this one, like hello or hi everybody, hi everyone, good morning, good afternoon, and so on. And you may thanks to your audience, thank my audience for coming or joining the presentation today. Okay, wait, yeah. And then next, after you have greeting the audience, this is how you deliver your content of your presentation. The first one is saying what your topic is. Yeah, kira-kira topiknya tentang apa? Misalnya, today's topic is about the theory of presentation. Atau mungkin, my topic today is going to present about how to change your healthy lifestyle. Misalnya seperti itu. Okay, the topic today is how to cope with the cancer. Misalnya seperti itu. Topik-topik tentang kesehatan is okay. Or maybe another topics that you are going to present. And then structuring a presentation. Okay, setelah menjelaskan topiknya itu apa, then you are going to deliver the content. This is I've divided my presentation into misalnya three part ya, tiga bagian. The first by explaining, the next showing the example, and then after this you have moved to the next point. Misalnya seperti itu, ada first, ada second, next, after that, and so on. Itu sudah ada semua di buku di halaman 71 ya. Yeah. I'm going to talk about and then the purpose of my presentation is, and then the last one is how you share your content presentation by using transition. Nah, ini maksudnya structuring a presentation ini kalau di buku adalah using transitions, ya. Ada use transition, ada giving example, ada giving reason, contrast, or the result. Okay. The next one is how you close your presentation. Okay. How to close your presentations here by giving thanks to your audience. Okay. Thank you for listening or taking part. Okay. Or thanks you for the coming. Atau you asking for the question. Are there any questions? Or maybe does anyone have any question or comment? Something like this one. Okay, if there is no comment, you may close your presentation. It means that your audience must already got what you have already talked about. Itu biasanya seperti itu. How you close your presentation. Okay, sebenarnya kalau presentasi itu kan memang cuma tiga part ya. Opening, delivering, dan closing. Okay. And here, the most important thing that you are going to take a note on your presentation is verbal and non-verbal communication. The first one is your body language and also your voice. This is the most important one. The body language here is your posture, your movement. I mean, it's here. Jadi, gak harus di satu tempat, bisa in your stage here, misalnya di depan ya. Bisa ke samping kanan, samping kiri, atau move to your audience here. Yeah. And then the eye contact. Okay. The eye contact, you have to look your audience. Not needed for you only reading your note. And then facial expression. So, biasanya kalau dalam presentasi itu, paling tidak kita kan harus senyum ya. Yeah. Okay. And then hand gesture. Biasanya ada juga yang presenter itu mempresentasikan menggunakan gesture dari hands. And then appropriate dress, okay. It's not needed for you because when you have the practice for your presentation, all of you are going to wear the uniform. And then the voice, okay. The voice, it means belong to volume, inflection, articulation, and also the rate. Okay, sebenarnya di sini ada juga yaitu times ya. Waktu, how you manage your time when you are going to present. Jadi misalnya kalau saya kasih tugas presentasi paling tidak 15 menit. Okay. For the 3 minute, 2 minute, or 3 minute you have the opening. Kemudian delivering-nya itu mungkin 5 menit. And then asking question is 5 minute. Misalnya seperti itu. Jadi tidak perlu lama sampai setengah jam atau mungkin 40 menit sampai 1 jam. Jadi biasanya kalau practice presentation, especially in English, saya itu tidak terlalu lama. Misalnya satu orang hanya 15 menit. Okay. 15 menit kalau ngomong bahasa Inggris mungkin ini ya, lama juga ya.
Rasa 2 jam, Miss.
Oke, okay. Ya. Yeah. Alright, so I will give you this. I will show you this one. Okay. How to play the effective presentation? Okay, silakan simak dulu videonya. Nanti setelah video, I will give you the task.
Once you have researched your presentation topic and know what you want to say, it is important to know how to deliver the information. This video will explain how to engage with your audience in order to deliver an effective presentation. Be aware of your nonverbal communication. Use body language that shows confidence. Have good posture. Smile and act relaxed. It will make you look more confident and it will make you feel more confident. make eye contact with your audience instead of reading off your notes the entire time. Avoid distracting behaviors like chewing gum. Watch for nervous gestures such as rocking, tapping, or fidgeting. You should also make sure to dress appropriately for your profession. Take time to think during your presentation. People have a tendency to speak more quickly under pressure. Make an effort to slow your pace and include pauses. Speaking slower will also help you avoid excessive verbal fillers like up or ah. Pay attention to your volume. Think about projecting your voice to the back of the classroom so that everyone can hear what you have to say. Try to speak clearly so that your audience can easily understand your words. Engage your audience. Avoid the lecture. By incorporating more than a speech into your presentation, you'll be better able to hold your audience's attention. Try using visuals, asking questions, or doing activities. Practice your presentation. You'll be more comfortable delivering your presentation if you know it well. Make sure you give yourself enough time to put your presentation together and practice it several times. If you are using visuals, you should know them well enough that you are not constantly looking at the screen and having your back or side to the audience. We hope that these tips can help you deliver an effective presentation.
So this one is, okay. This is the summarizing of this video ya. Jadi ini adalah summarize dari video tadi tentang how you deliver the effective presentations here. The first one is have confident body language. Okay. Biasanya kalau presentasi di depan kan ada ya nervous ya. The most important things is you have to be confident. Yeah, and then make eye contact here. Yeah. Jadi tadi penjelasannya sudah ada sebelum ini. Kemudian avoid distracting behavior. Oke, maksudnya apa ini? Yes, apa tadi? Avoid distracting behavior. Apa? Menghindari apa? Menghindari hal-hal yang mengganggu ya. Misalnya tiba-tiba dalam mempresentasikan, tiba-tiba mau makan atau minum. Oke, okay. It's okay if you wanna have some drink, but you have to give some permission to your audience. Misalnya seperti itu, kalau mau minum dulu, it's okay, tapi biasanya meminta izin dulu ya. Atau you have some permission to your audience. Kemudian speak clearly. Oke, okay, jadi harus clear. Oke, okay, through the volumes or the pronunciation, especially in English, your pronunciation is most important things. Ya, yeah, your pronunciation. Jangan mumble atau geremeng, ya. Yeah. And the next one is project your voice. Ini juga related to the how you speak clearly. And then take your time. Okay, tadi yang sudah saya sampaikan, you have to set your time. Ya, how many ya hours you have to present? How many minutes you present your presentations here? You have to set your time. And then engage your audience. Kalau tadi di video, it is how you have to avoid the lectures. Jadi jangan terlalu banyak ceramah, you have to engage your audience by asking questions, misalnya seperti itu. And then you have to practice and then know your visual. Okay, jadi di sini adalah how you set your visual yang mau ditunjukkan ke audience itu apa, seperti itu. Okay, I will close this one and then I will stop to share this PowerPoint. Now time for you to take the small practice of the presentation to the opening, delivering, or closing. Ya. Yeah. Jadi nanti saya panggil satu-satu untuk praktek delivering, opening, and closing ya. Oke. Jadi nanti kalau saya panggil namanya, you have to act like having the presentation. Jadi misalnya nanti saya panggil namanya dari absen nomor 1 misalnya ya, Siti Aisa, please pretend to have the opening of presentation. Oke, misalnya Siti Aisa saya suruh untuk pretend to have the presentation, the opening of presentation. Jadi langsung nanti how you greet your audience. Ya. Yeah. Jadi satu anak misalnya tentang opening, kemudian satu anak nanti tentang delivering, kemudian satu anak lagi tentang closing, misalnya seperti itu ya. Oke, okay, are you ready?
Ready, Miss.
Oke, okay, ready ya. Hari saja ini yang ready, yang lainnya? Oke, okay, understand ya? What you are going to present after this? Oke, okay, paling prakteknya cuma 30 menit, 10 menitan kok ya. 10 menit untuk beberapa mahasiswa di sini saya tunjuk. Oke. Okay. I will share this one. Oke. Okay. Jadi greetings, kalau yang di sini adalah delivering, kalau yang di sini adalah closings. Oke. Okay. I will take your attendance list please. Satu, Siti Aisa, where is Siti Aisa?
Yes, Miss.
Okay. Could you please could you pretend to have the opening of presentation? Okay, ayo silakan coba bagaimana membuka presentasi ya, opening presentasi in English. One. Seperti presentasi biasanya, cuma ngomongnya dalam bahasa Inggris gitu aja.
Oke. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oke. Okay. My name is Siti Aisa. I will a presentation.
Ya, go on. Jangan takut salah grammarnya, nanti saya komen di akhir.
Iya, Miss. Langsung ke topik ini, Miss.
Enggak, opening saja. Openingnya saja. Enggak usah topik, opening. Satu aja, nanti kalau saya suruh opening, closing, sama delivering terlalu lama ya. Opening aja dulu.
I will presentasi.
Gini ya, bisa baca di buku, nggak apa-apa. Okay. Karena ini kan hanya present, apa namanya? Praktek saja. Kalau nanti prakteknya yang benar-benar praktek itu kan setelah luring. Oke. Sekarang boleh kalau menggunakan di buku. Tadi greeting sudah, introduce yourself sudah. And then
outline your talk.
Ya, outline your talk ini masuk opening atau masuk delivering?
Delivering.
Ya, delivering ini ya. Jadi sudah cukup yang ini tadi ya. You greet your audience, saja assalamualaikum atau tadi good morning ya. And then so my name is Siti Aisa. Okay. In this occasion, I want to present. Ya, bukan I am presentation. Kalau I am presentation berarti saya presentasi gitu ya. I want to talk about atau I am going to present. Ini di sini. Di bukunya silakan dibaca itu. Good morning, teacher and friend atau ladies and gentlemen. I would like to say thank you atau it's great to see you, my audience. seperti itu. Jadi di sini ada basa-basinya, jadi nggak langsung assalamualaikum kemudian good morning. Mungkin di sini ada apa ya, tambahan ya, tambahan kata. You may add some to engage your audience, I mean here. Yeah. Kemudian introduce yourself. Oke. Okay. Alright, thank you Aisyah. Satu Aisyah ya. Dua. Next. Tadi masih kurang sempurna. Siti Nurhalisa, where is Siti Nurhalisa?
Yes, Miss.
Ya, sekarang opening lagi. Opening yang lebih sempurna, ayo. You have to act the opening of the presentation.
Assalamualaikum, friends.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Here we from group 2 will present the result of our group work and
okay. Finish?
Yes, miss.
Okay, cukup ya. Alright, so this is your group presentations. Yeah, you may greet your audience and you introduce your group. Ya, kalau introduce your group biasanya diperkenalkan satu-satu ya. Misalnya si A, ya going to present for the first or the second topic, and then kemudian yang satu sebagai apa, yang satu sebagai apa. Biasanya seperti itu kalau yang in group. Okay, but so far is okay. Thank you, Halisa. Next. Siti Nurhanisa.
Okay, Miss.
Okay, go on. Siti Nurhanisa, wait. The opening of presentation, go on. Masih opening ya. Masih opening of presentations. Ayo, Nurhanisa.
Okay, Miss. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Siti Nurhanisa. I will before we start our class. I will before we start a presentation.
Gimana? Enough? Cukup atau mau nambah lagi kata-katanya? Go on. Halisa, Halisa ya. Mau ditambah lagi atau cukup?
Cukup, Miss.
Cukup, oke. Okay. Ya, jadi I explain more when you have you greet your audience, okay? You may add some thinking, ya. Jadi di sini selain good morning everybody, ya. Di sini juga bisa dikasih kata apa? Thank you. Di bukunya halaman 71 silakan dibaca ya. Jadi setelah good morning, you may say it's great to see you, friend, atau thank you for coming to my presentation. Okay, here I am Nur Hanisah, misalnya seperti itu. I'm going to present. Jadi, you may say I'm going to present atau I will present, ya, atau I will talk about. Jadi setelah will itu verb satu, ya, kata-kata atau if you are going to have to be plus going to bisa juga I will atau I'm going to. Jadi itu kuncinya, I'm going to atau I will. Satu lagi untuk yang opening. Siti Nur Kasih.
Yes, Miss.
Ya, ayo opening dulu. Opening lagi.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone.
Hello. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi.
Good morning. And how are you today?
Okay, good morning. I'm fine.
Good morning to
It's great to see you all, and I'm Cassie. I will talk about healthy food. And
good. Jadi you may add something cute to your friend and then introduce your friends and how you present your topic. Okay, good. Thank you, Kasih. Okay, panggilannya Kasih ya.
Yes.
Alright. Next, Sri Wahyuni. Where is Sri Wahyuni? Sri Wahyuni, are you here?
Yeah, Miss.
Okay, yeah, go on. Sri Wahyuni, sebentar lagi, you have to pretend. Yeah, to pretend your presentation on delivering. Jadi yang ini masuk konten ya. Kontennya di sini. Training your talk atau move to the body atau summarizing atau concluding. Terserah mau pilih yang mana. Mau langsung summarize, mau langsung concluding atau sedikit tentang content. Ayo, delivering. Terserah mau topik apa saja atau giving some tip is okay. For example, saya kasih contoh ya. Alright, today I have the topic about how giving some tips ya, how to get a healthy diet. Okay, in this topic I will divide it into three part. The first one is some tip of healthy diet. The second one is the example of healthy diet, and then the last one is the practice how to get the healthy diet. Misalnya seperti itu. Yeah, ayo. Giving some tip is okay. Giving information is okay. Yeah, atau you may sell your product is okay. Di sini mungkin yang sudah praktek jualan online bisa ya. Di sini praktek your online shop is okay. Ayo, delivering ya. Waktunya cuma 1 atau 2 menit. Sri Wahyuni ya, go on. Ayo Wahyu.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning all. Let me introduce myself. My name is Sri Wahyuni. I am here to present about therapeutic communication.
Okay. Ya, outlining your thoughts atau summarizing your thoughts. Tadi kan topiknya sudah dikasih tahu ya. I will talk about therapeutic communication. Okay, dalam therapeutic communication nanti dalam menjelaskan mau dibagi berapa part. Misalnya the first, the second, the third, misalnya seperti itu. Go on.
Ya Allah, kedatang.
Yes. Gimana, apa intinya dari terapeutik itu nanti yang mau dijelaskan apa? Apa pertama penjelasan dulu, kemudian mungkin ada contoh-contoh, kemudian mungkin ada you wanna show your video about therapeutic, seperti itu. Go on. Gak perlu dijelaskan terapeutik itu tentang apa bla bla, no. Jadi urutannya saja. Di sini yang saya nilai itu hanya how you deliver your presentations in a good way for the structuring your presentation, I mean. Okay, go on. Atau langsung closing sudah, nggak apa-apa langsung closing. How you close your presentations? Ayo, Wahyu. Wahyu. Enough. Cukup ya?
Ya.
Cukup, oke. Tadi nyebutkan topiknya saja, tapi setelah itu outlining-nya macet ya. Ya, nggak apa-apa, it's okay. Nanti dipraktek yang kelas luring saja. Oke, the last one. Ini saya butuh satu lagi aja. Suci Wulandari, very Suci.
Excuse me, Miss. Suci izin membeli paket data, Miss.
Oh, membeli paket data untuk... Ini nggak pakai wifi ta? Nggak di kampus?
Tidak, Miss.
Oke, okay, you are in home. Oke, okay, izin ya. Next we have Supriyatin.
Yes, Miss.
Yeah, go on. So how to close your presentation. Jadi contoh menutup presentasi, udah itu aja. Kalau yang delivering nanti mungkin masih mikir topiknya ya. Yang concluding aja. Yang close, how you close your presentations in English. Oke, okay, ayo.
That's a lot of presentation from me. More and less, I'm sorry. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, yeah, okay, good. Sorry. You miss one point is how you invite your questions. Yeah. Okay, mungkin satu lagi tambahan. Sahrul, mana Sahrul? Sahrul Jaya Putra.
Tidak, Miss.
Sahrul.
Iya, Miss.
Ya, ayo. You turn on your video, please. Turn on your video and then you have to give the example of closing presentation. Ayo, Sahrul.
I would like to thank you for your time and attention. Assalamualaikum.
Oh, ya, enggak apa-apa. Ayo suaranya aja enggak apa-apa dah. Come on. How you close your presentation in English?
I would like to thank you for your time and attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, ya. Jadi seperti itu ya. Atau mungkin you may have some question and you have to answer the question. Thank for the question, thank for your comments for the audience and then you say thank you. Alright, so untuk yang lainnya nanti di sesi yang kedua ya. Oke, we have one more topik. Jadi ada satu topik lagi yaitu presentasi part 2. Okay, I have to close this one. Nanti yang lainnya di praktek yang itu ya. Okay. Okay, I have to stop to share this PowerPoint and we move to we move to the others topic, ya. Yeah. Okay, silakan istirahat dulu, nggak apa-apa. Maybe you have to some drinks, some snacking is okay. Only 1 to 2 minutes, 1 sampai 2 minit nggak apa-apa sambil minum ya. Yeah.
Because
we have one more topic. Jadi ada satu topik lagi. Sama tentang presentasi, cuma presentasinya yang part 2 yaitu how you set your this one. Okay. Sorry, I have to take some drink ya. Saya minum dulu. Set your visual presentation. Jadi untuk topik yang kedua di sini saya ya judul adalah visual presentation. Jadi di sini bagaimana you prepare your visual presentations. Kalau di buku di sini adalah yang making PowerPoint ya. How to delivering PowerPoints. Kalau di silabus juga kemarin kalau nggak salah saya baca. Bentar, saya cek dulu silabusnya. Okay. Kemarin, sorry, di silabus yaitu theory of presentation, kemudian theory of presentation 2 yaitu how to make PowerPoint slide atau making PowerPoint slide. Ya, di buku itu di halaman 72. Cuma di sini saya lebih prefer to have the title of set your visual presentation. Jadi di sini visual presentations means it can be a PowerPoint, it can be through the video, it can be the other visuals that you can use for your presentations. Kalau PowerPoint mungkin ini di comments ya, commonly used. Okay, saya kasih pertanyaan dulu. What is visual presentation commonly used? Okay, ini salah satu jawabannya adalah PowerPoint ya. Visual presentasi yang biasa digunakan itu adalah PowerPoint. Okay, is it right? Or maybe you have another kind of visual PowerPoint that you usually use in your presentations? Mungkin ada yang menggunakan selain PowerPoint. Kira-kira apa?
Poster, Miss.
Yes.
Or leaflet, Miss.
Yes, what else? Okay, biasanya itu ya. Okay, the most important thing is the visual presentation is here is to help you in delivering your presentations. Okay. Kemudian how to design the visual presentation more attractive? Okay, it is depend on your skill. Ya, it depend on your skill. Jadi biasanya visual presentation itu akan lebih menarik Kalau di desain menarik mungkin tergantung dari skill kalian mau atau selera ya. Biasanya ada yang suka simple, ada yang suka rame, seperti itu desainnya yang agak rame, ada yang simple, kemudian mungkin ada yang ya just so-so misalnya seperti itu. Oke. Okay. Among all of you here, biasanya siapa di sini yang jago banget untuk membuat visual presentation?
Jago semua, Miss.
Jago semua ya. Oke, nanti kita lihat ketika prakteknya ya. I will give you some score to your visual presentation. Misalnya seperti itu. Kalau saya, kalau mahasiswa presentasi itu tidak hanya dilihat dari materinya saja, tapi visual presentasinya itu juga ada nilainya. Ya, selain your how you deliver your presentation itself, the most important thing is visual presentation. Karena visual presentasi itu kalau kurang menarik, nanti audiennya juga ini tidak menarik juga seperti itu, kurang mendengarkan. Ya. Okay, next, what are the advantages of using slide atau visual presentations here? Kira-kira manfaat dari menggunakan visual presentation dalam presentasi itu apa? Yes, ada yang...
Bukan, Miss.
Apa?
Bisa dimengerti, Miss.
Dimengerti, ya. Yeah. Say in English.
Enggak ngerti.
It is easy to be understand, ya. Yeah. Easy to be understood, mudah dimengerti. Oke, okay. Berarti sebelum join the class, ini semuanya belum dibaca ya bukunya ya. Have you read your textbook before join
no,
the
miss.
Class?
No, miss.
No. I have no time, ya. Yeah. You have no time to read your textbook, but you have more time to read some status, okay, to read
yes,
some
miss.
Instagram, yeah.
Okay. Right, Miss.
Yeah, this right. Jadi di halaman 72, silakan dibuka halaman 72, itu di sana sudah ada the advantages of using slide in PowerPoint atau the advantages of using visual presentation. Salah satunya di sana. Quick and easy to organize. Okay, apalagi itu?
PowerPoint slides are generally easier to see by the audience when project than other visual aids.
Ya, biasanya seperti itu. Memang kelebihan dari PowerPoint itu dari visual aid yang lainnya itu lebih dimengerti atau lebih banyak digunakan ya, diaplikasikan. Kemudian improving audience fokus ya, biasanya audiens itu juga fokus sama visual yang kalian tunjukkan tadi, yang kalian gunakan. Atau kemudian apa lagi itu? It is so fun to watch by audience. Oke, okay. Atau mungkin handbook biasanya. Easy to create colorful or attractive design atau easy to modify. Oke, okay, jadi di sini banyak sekali advantages-nya. You may read by yourself. Oke. Okay. Next, the most important thing that I have to share for you is how to give the good layout or the bad layout for your visual presentations here, like this one. You may have the comparisons here. This is the heading one, it is the heading two. Okay, this is the good one and this is the bad one. Okay, kira-kira perbedaannya apa dari good sama bad ini? Ada yang bisa jelaskan? Kenapa heading yang ini bisa dikatakan good? Kenapa heading yang di sini ini termasuk kategori bad? Okay, anyone want to comment?
Saya Miss, tapi pakai bahasa Indonesia ya, Miss.
Pakai bahasa Indonesia di mix ya. Okay, go on, di mix. Jadi belajar how you speak your English. Saya nggak akan marahi kok ya, Riz ya.
Gimana, Miss?
Panggilannya siapa ini? Panggilannya tolak apa Haris?
Haris, Miss.
Riz, saya Riz.
Menurut saya, Miss, karena kan kalau saya sering ikut seminar itu PPT itu harus nggak boleh bertele-tele, Miss. Kalau ya yang bad itu terlalu bertele-tele karena dia langsung menjelaskan kita ketika presentasi itu yang dinilai kemampuan kita dalam menyampaikan materi, Miss. Kalau di good kenapa kok cuma sedikit-sedikit. Jadi diambil intinya saja, Miss, yang ditaruh di PPT. Selebihnya kita kembangkan sendiri, Miss.
Okay, good comments. Okay, could you translate your speaking in English? Yang tadi kamu omongkan itu translate dalam bahasa Inggris. Gimana intinya? Ayo coba ngomong bahasa Inggris.
Bentar, Miss, mau buka Google Translate.
Buka Google Translate. Okay, kelamaan. Ayo, yang lainnya. Yang lain tadi kan sudah dengarkan penjelasannya Haris ya. Oke, itu dalam bahasa Indonesia. Kira-kira ada yang bisa mentranslate penjelasannya Haris dalam bahasa Inggris tanpa menggunakan Google Translate? Go on, yang lain. Raise your hands. Atau turn on your audio, kemudian langsung ngomong. Go on, yang lain.
Saya, Miss.
Oke, your name, please.
My name is Fania.
Go on, Fania. You have to comparing the good layout or bad layout. Tadi yang diungkapkan Haris sudah benar ya, komennya is good. Sekarang you have translate in Indonesia, in English.
Okay. In good layout in PowerPoint, maybe only some point of the topic, but itu.
Yes, what the bad layout? Gimana?
In this example, it kalimatnya terlalu kompleks.
Kalimatnya terlalu kompleks. How do you say in English? Kalimat itu apa bahasa Inggrisnya?
Aduh.
Sentence.
Ya, sentence.
Oke. Okay. Ada lagi? Enough, Fania?
Enough, Miss.
Oke, okay, enough ya. Ya, jadi gini intinya itu for headings here, you only set the point of your topic. Ya, yeah. Okay, this is only the point of your topics. For example, the fact one, you have to elaborate, you have to explain the fact ones, what is it about. Okay, and then fact two, what is it about. And then fact three, and so on. It's not needed for you to have some kind of reading, ya. Yeah? Ini kan seperti reading. Yeah, your audience is not needed to read all this one in the whole pages here. Yeah, jadi itu perbandingannya. It's not like such of reading. This one only the topic. Okay. Mungkin semua ya, sebenarnya kalian semua sudah paham ya. Cuma how you delivering your English itu mungkin yang jadi kendala ya. Kendalanya adalah bagaimana menyampaikan dalam bahasa Inggris gitu aja. Kalau suruh menyampaikan bahasa Indonesia, oh pinter-pinter semua ya. Oke, berarti harus belajar nanti ketika you have practice the presentation in English. Oke, but don't worry, you will be able to speak more in English. Next. After you have good layout and bad layout, you have this one. You have to choose your readable color and font. Okay, this is the first one belong to good and the bad one and the awful ones. Okay, silakan di komen lagi. Siapa yang mau menjelaskan kenapa ini, why is belong to the good one, why is it called bad and this one is so awful. Silakan dijelaskan. Once. try to speak English. Kenapa saya sengaja seperti ini? Karena saya mau mendengarkan your sexy voice in speaking English. Ya. Yeah. Kan ini kelas bahasa Inggris, jadi saya pengen ngerti kemampuan mahasiswa kelas 20D ini dalam ngomong bahasa Inggris. Go on. Siapa yang berani? Who want to try to give the comment? Why is it good? Why is it bad? And why is it so awful? Related to readable color and font. Go on. Ayo, kasih komen. Pakai bahasa Inggris ya. Yuk, siapa yuk? Hari sama Fania, jangan komen dulu. Kasih kesempatan sama yang lain ya. Go on, mungkin Esti, Wilda.
Hi, Miss.
Okay, your name please. Namanya siapa?
Dia.
Dia.
Because there is everything that is not clear collects with the color. Because there is everything that is not clear, it collects with the color.
Okay, the writing is not clear related to the color here, yeah. Jadi, if you have the color like this one, blue, or this one like, what is it? A black, jadi black and white, gitu tulisannya ya. Kalau layarnya itu white, jadi yang langsung readable, jadi yang langsung enak dibaca. Kalau yang ini kan masih kurang suitable for the color. Ini kurang pas colornya. Kalau yang ini selain colornya nggak pas, juga the font of the, okay, the fonts ya, yeah, the option of the fonts ya. Yeah. Jadi pemilihan dari fontnya itu juga kurang pas, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay, good, thank you, dia. Alright, next after you have just the readable color and fonts, okay, here I will give you some practice how to the effective visual presentations. Oke, okay. Jadi bagaimana membuat visual presentasi itu yang efektif, ya. Yeah. Okay, let's see the video, and then you have the comment of the video.
Everything you're about to watch was created using PowerPoint. Editable, flexible, presentable. Let's think for a while about how making your slides clearer and readable. It's the words you see and the words you hear processed in a single part of the brain. Same time. So when faced with text in these lines, text for slides, use pictures, diagrams, and graphs that illustrate and reinforce your messages, but are completely self-explanatory. Professionally designed to give a wide impression and colors,
Is it clear? Jadi ada berapa poin tadi? Ada 3 poin ya sebenarnya di awal-awal itu. Kalau presentasi, visual presentasinya itu harus apa? Oke, apa ini? Jadi intinya itu ada 3 untuk membuat visual presentation, especially for PowerPoint. Apa saja tadi? Yes? Okay, you get it or no? Apa ini?
Editable, flexible, presentable.
Okay, apa aja?
Gak kedengeran, Miss.
Gak kedengeran. Oh, I see. Tapi tadi kan penjelasannya sudah jelas ya. Suaranya kurang ini, kurang keras atau kurang jelas?
Tadi suaranya itu kadang muncul, kadang
hilang. Iya, Miss. Hilang timbul, Miss.
Oh, I see. Jadi intinya itu adalah presentable, effective, dan juga relatable, ya. Jadi di sini itu tadi video itu menjelaskan sebenarnya menjelaskan yang tadi itu bad layout sama good layout atau yang readable color and readable font seperti itu. Jadi intinya seperti itu tadi. Okay, next we have ini baru saya kasih contoh yang bad and good presentation ya. Silakan tonton juga videonya. Nanti silakan kasih komen setelah nonton video ini. Saya tunjuk nanti satu-satu.
Videonya nggak muncul, Miss.
Kenapa?
Videonya di kami nggak muncul.
Oh, nggak muncul.
Hanya suara.
Hanya suara, Miss. Tapi suaranya hilang timbul, Miss.
Oh, I see. Semuanya nggak muncul ini videonya?
Iya, Miss. Okay, Miss. Dari tadi, Miss.
Dari tadi.
Miss. Dari di awal tadi, dah, Miss.
Oh, I see. You use your menggunakan apa namanya? Sorry, menggunakan handphone atau laptop?
Laptop, Miss. Kalau video itu biasanya ada setting khusus, Miss. Laptop, Miss.
Biasanya ini keluar kalau laptop ya. Kemarin di kelas lainnya nggak ada kendala sih. Ya, masih nggak kelihatan ya?
Masih, Miss. Masih nggak kelihatan, Miss.
Oke, mungkin salah satu dari kalian ada yang kelihatan atau tidak?
Tidak kelihatan, Miss.
Tidak, Miss. Nggak, hanya suara saja?
Iya, Miss.
Iya, Miss. Hanya suara
dari tadi
saja.
Seperti itu, Miss.
Oh, I see. Only the
first, Miss.
Sounds ya. Jadi soundnya saja yang kedengeran. Jadi visualnya nggak keluar, nggak kedengeran videonya ya?
No, Miss.
No, okay. Jadi saya stop sharing dulu. Nanti saya buka di video lainnya ya. Sebentar ya. Wait. Okay. Tadi kok enggak komen waktu presentasi yang awal. Saya kira itu lancar aja kalian melihat videonya.
Tak kirain cuma suara aja memang, Miss.
No, jadi kalau listening baru suara aja. Ya, karena ini presentasi, jadi kalian harus melihat video ini. Jadi ada 3 video sebenarnya. Ini yang terakhir. Wait. Sebentar. I will give this one for the media player. This one.
Hello.
Rachel speaking. Today's first presenter is Rachel.
Okay, are you selfie for the this one? Okay, kira-kira?
Yes, miss.
Can you see the video?
I see, miss.
Okay. Sebentar, Haris aja atau yang lainnya yang udah kelihatan juga yang lainnya?
Kelihatan, yes, miss.
Okay, kelihatan ya videonya ya?
Okay, kelihatan, right, miss.
You have to give the comment ya, kan tadi sudah saya bilang you will see the video. Oke, okay, berarti dari tadi cuma dengan suaranya. Oh my,
yes,
god,
miss.
Why you didn't instruct me to this kind of? Ya, oke, okay, saya simpan dari awal ya. Oke, okay. Ini kalau video itu kan gini, meskipun kita dengarnya kurang jelas, tapi kan dari video itu kita bisa mereka-reka untuk artinya apa, maksudnya apa ya. Oke, okay, next.
Hello everyone, welcome to public speaking. Today's first presenter is Ranjit. Ask everyone to give them their full attention. Shanta, would you dim the lights, please?
British imposed a lot of unpopular taxes on the American colonists and didn't let them elect representatives to the British government. In retaliation, the Americans started to boycott British goods. In 1773, Americans in Massachusetts dumped a shipload of British tea into Boston Harbor. This became known as the Boston Tea Party. As punishment, the British imposed laws known as the Intolerable Acts, including the Quartering Act, which made Americans let British soldiers live in their homes. Some of the American colonies created a Declaration of Rights and Grievances, which they sent to Britain, but the British just sent soldiers to the colonies to put down any rebellion. This led to the first battles of the Revolution at Lexington. Presentation will be about the causes and effects of stress. Good morning. Today I'd like to talk about the causes and effects of stress and clinical stress. Events, changes, or unrealistic expectations of yourself. Some effects of stress include headaches, sleeping, last year I started working after school to save for college, but I didn't have time to do homework and my grades were down. I had trouble sleeping, I only ate junk food, and I stopped hanging out with my friends. Unfortunately, I was able to talk with a school counselor to manage my stress. She suggested that I reduce my hours at my job, eat healthy foods, and get some exercise. So I literally started walking home from school and bringing my lunch. I also asked my teachers for extra help. Now, I feel better. It's important to recognize when you're stressed and to ask for help. Thank you. Lunch. He spoke, he smiled, and he used the purpose and to help us feel open.
Okay, so you get it, this one, yeah? This video? Okay, this is the first one. Okay, the first one is belong to bad presentations, and the second presentation from Raj is here. Okay, the next letter. This one is the good ones. Yeah. Okay, kira-kira apa perbedaannya yang kalian lihat? What can you learn from this video? From the bad one and the third, sorry, the good one. Silakan kasih komen. Saya panggil Tarisa Aprilia Putri. Tarisa. Tarisa. Gak ada Tarisa ya.
Mohon maaf, Miss. Putus-putus, Miss.
Alright, Tarisa. Next, Tolak Haris. Ayo Haris. Could you give comment from these two video? Perbandingannya dari bad sama yang good, the ones?
Pakai bahasa Inggris ya, Miss?
Iyalah, pakai bahasa Inggris. Kalau pakai bahasa Indonesia, saya tolak ya.
Jangan, harus aja, Miss.
Ya, yeah. The ones.
Gimana ya, Miss? Bingung saya mau ngomong bahasa Inggris, Miss.
Ayo, Haris.
Bingung, Miss. Bahasa Inggris, Miss.
Pakai bahasa Inggris. Sebisanya, Haris. Sudah. Sebisanya, Haris. Sebisanya, Haris, gimana? Your comment to this video. The first presenter and the second presentation.
Yang bad itu is... gimana ya, Miss? yeah, in bed to apa ya, Miss? Bingung bahasa Inggrisnya sih, Miss.
Bingung bahasa Inggrisnya ya.
Bahasa Inggrisnya anu, Miss. Apa terlalu membosankan gitu, Miss?
Very boring.
Boring.
Yeah.
Yeah, the bad one is boring the bad and the is, second is one never.
The second good the in presentation can understand in audience, Miss.
Oke, jadi yang pertama boring, yang kedua itu lebih dimengerti gitu ya, lebih
yes,
jelas.
Miss.
Okay, yes, more understand by the audience and the audience is not boring and for the bad one is getting bored. Okay, thank you. Kemudian komen selanjutnya, Tri Zara Safriani. Tri Zara Safriani. Tri Zara, Tri Zara enggak ada?
Alfa dan tapi kecil suara.
Oke, lanjut ke Ulfa Maimuna. Ayo Ulfa.
Okay,
could you give the comment from the bad one and the good one of this presentation?
Ini apa yang yang presentation itu apa ya Miss yang itu the first presentation intinya gini Miss yang presentasi pertama nah itu kan
say in English
the first presentation sebentar deh yang itu the first presentation good nah because si pembela ini nih si present si apa itu
presenter
ya? Yang present si presenternya itu ininya Miss kayak tadi itu kalau tidak salah ya Miss si audience itu kita diulang ya Miss.
Oke, okay, belibet banget ya. Ayo, komennya itu yang jelas gitu yang intinya itu apa? Ya. Oke, okay, come on.
Ini yang the first presentation itu good because bukan salah yang the first presentation itu bad news because si audience itu draw Naruto Miss kayak presentasinya itu kayak boring gitu.
Next
yang the second presentationnya yang the second presentation good nah because audience feel comfortable.
Alright, stay good, thank you. Nabila Hairunisa, ayo Nabila kasih komen.
Yeah, for the first presentation, he need to speak more, lebih keras, louder.
Okay.
And he was always reading the paper. So he don't a contact with the audience.
All right, good.
For the
good one.
For the second presentation, the man is more confident. Yeah, sudah Miss.
It's all ya, yeah? Okay. We well prepared. Okay, ya, yeah, thank you Nabila. Jadi, the first presentation is the means ya, the presenter is not to be confident. Ya, jadi intinya itu ketika when you get presentation, the key is confident. Jadi harus percaya diri dulu ya. If you do not confident, means like the first presenter, ya, reading and so on, is not well prepared. Jadi ketika mau presentasi, yang terpenting adalah when you delivering your presentation is to be confident. Kemudian yang kedua harus well prepared. Jadi harus persiapannya matang ya. Like the visual presentation is here and also how you master your topic. Itu intinya. Jadi menguasai topik ketika presentasi ya. Kemudian confident. Okay, thank you Nabila. For the others, ya, yeah, untuk yang lainnya, maybe next meeting I will give you some command or task. Jadi untuk yang lain yang belum saya sebutkan, nanti di meeting selanjutnya, ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Sudah saya catat semua di sini nama-namanya. I think that's enough for our meeting today, ya. Yeah. Kira-kira sebelum saya tutup, ada pertanyaan atau tidak?
Saya Miss.
Ya, yeah, go on.
Ini Miss, kan saya sekarang lagi proses ikut lomba ISA internasional Miss. Nah, saya bingung kan saya bahasa Inggrisnya sangat sangat buruk sekali Miss.
Oke, okay, lomba apa itu?
ISA internasional Miss.
Oh, I see.
Nah, terus itu kan nanti ketika saya lolos di jadi finalis Miss, itu kan presentasi pakai bahasa Inggris ya Miss. Ya. Ada tips buat saya dar dengan apa buat PPT-nya dan cara menjelaskannya nanti Miss yang sekiranya bisa dipahami tapi sebentar gitu Miss.
Oke okay, ya, yeah. How to present ya yeah, your presentation here. Yeah. Jadi kalau saya jelaskan di sini mungkin nanti you need more times ya. Yeah. Jadi intinya kalau misalnya nanti si Haris lolos, kita doakan saja semoga lolos ya. Oke, okay. Nanti you have
ya. Yeah.
Oke, okay. For your English speaking here, for ability you may chat in private with me ya, gitu aja ya. Kemudian untuk tips-tipsnya ya, tips-tipsnya sebenarnya satu itu tadi kuncinya adalah you have to be confident. Ya, confident itu tidak hanya percaya diri berdiri di depan, no, but confident with your, nah confident-nya itu banyak cabangnya ya. Confident with your English skill, ya, yeah. Confident with your English skill and confident with your mastering your topic. Intinya itu kalau presentasi itu adalah mastering your topic and also confident with your speaking. Itu aja, ya. Yeah. Jangan kalau hari saya lihat kata masih confidentnya masih kurang ya. Ketika tadi menyampaikan sebenarnya what you have in your mind, you have already what is it? Apa ya? Itu sudah di luar di kepala sebenarnya mau komen apa itu sudah ada konsepnya. Tapi what you have to talk about, you want to deliver is hard. Ya, yeah. Biasanya seperti itu. It's hard to say. Sebenarnya sudah ada di sini, tapi yang mau mengutarakan itu ya sulit kalau dalam bahasa Inggris. Nah, intinya apa ya, harus praktek banyak ngomong bahasa Inggris ya. Oke, gitu.
Siap Miss nanti private ke ya, Miss Amelia.
Gini bisa chat ini ya, nanti saya kasih tip-tip bagaimana you have to improve your speaking. Oke. Dulu English Day kan saya enggak di saya belum ngajar ya.
Oke. Belum Miss.
Belum. Ya, belum ya. Soalnya
belum,
saya
miss.
Off dari STIKES itu kurang lebih 3 semester. Waktu itu off. Sebelumnya saya ngajar lagi kemudian balik lagi because I had to postpone my ya my graduate school ya. Sebenarnya kan mau ini saya postpone 3 semester. Itu maunya lanjut S3 tapi kan ada kendala akhirnya balik lagi ke Jember seperti itu. Oke, jadi kalau di English Day, sorry, time is up ya? Belum ya? Biasanya saya kasih tip bagaimana how you improve your English gitu dalam waktu misalnya 3 bulan atau dalam waktu 1 bulan. Kuncinya adalah you have to be to manage your English time a day. Jadi dalam satu hari kalian harus punya waktu untuk English Day. Apa itu English Day? Ya, English time I mean ya. English Day for English time. Jadi dalam sehari kalian itu harus punya kalau harus memanage waktu 10 sampai 15 menit untuk bahasa Inggris. Kapan itu waktunya? Terserah kalian mau sebelum tidur, mau sesudah tidur atau mungkin ketika waktu you luang. Pokoknya dalam satu hari harus menyiapkan atau meluangkan 10 sampai 15 menit aja. Untuk apa? Untuk belajar bahasa Inggris. 10 sampai 15 menit. Saya dulu seperti itu, setiap hari 10 sampai 15 menit saja. Oke, belajar apa? Oke, kira-kira dalam 10-15 menit belajar apa? Belajar sesuka kalian. Misalnya kalian suka baca, kalian suka nonton video, semuanya in English. Jadi itu akan improve your English for a month. Jadi nanti akan kelihatan dalam sebulan kalian setiap hari menyisikan 10 sampai 15 menit dalam belajar bahasa Inggris akan kelihatan satu bulan nanti perkembangan your English seperti itu ya. Oke, itu saja tip dari saya untuk your improve your English. I think that's enough for today. Kalau mau lebih lanjut you may chat saya ya. Karena nanti lagi saya juga ada kelas. Thank you very much for today. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you so much, Miss.
I have mistaken for Thank
yes, you. Miss. Thank you so much, Miss. Good day, ya guys. Saya end meeting ya guys. And I in Zoom and end meeting. You keluar semua.
Yes, yes.
Kurisong.